course, Buddy wants his close up. Buddy, you're supposed to stay back here so I can do this video. Come on, killer. Come on. Turn this way. Move that butt. Hey, no, not that way. There you go. Get the pressure this way. Good boy. Come here. Good boy. Okay, halter and a horse. I tried to demonstrate this. I think I've talked about it on other videos, but it still seems to be a lost art of some sort. When you're haltering your horse, you notice I have this tied around Buddy's head. Of course, he don't want to listen. He's chicken on crack. You gotta pay attention. Good boy. Hey, stop. I'm gonna have to get tough on him in a minute, just making sure that he knows I'm paying attention. You gotta let me do this video. People, you halter a horse, this is just tying, so ignore this. This is my head. When I'm dealing with a horse, I talk about on my horse thoughts page about controlling your horse without a halter. If I want to take a picture of Buddy, I should be able to use a soft touch without a halter, get him to look where I want to touch him, pet him, and slowly control him and make this look like a decent, easy picture. I shouldn't have to have a chain and a rope and I'm holding and I'm smiling and I'm holding. That's not how you show that you have communication with your horse. Buddy's got his head over there. If I want his head here, he should come when I ask him to. When I pick up, put pressure, he should give to me. If I want his head next to me, I should be able to put it there. So that's learning feel and timing. Now, when you put on a rope halter or any halter for that matter, you do it from the left side, but I see all this crap to where people are throwing it over the horse's neck. It just drives me nuts. They hit him in the eye, they hit him in the ear, they laugh about it. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, I'm sorry, baby. I didn't mean to hit you. You teach a horse swinging things that it hurts. That's not good. That's not how you put on a halter. I want my horse to be relaxed when I put the halter on. I want him to know that sometimes he's not going to get slapped because I'm too uncoordinated or stupid to not be able to throw a rope over him. So, after Buddy gets finished with his itch here, good boy, bud, come here. Getting a horse is catching him. Now, you can catch him or gain control of him several ways. I can put my hand around him, gain control this way. I can hug him, gain control this way. I can take a lead rope, and people want to throw it over the head and reach under and grab it. No, put it in your other hand, give your horse a pet, a rub, calmly reach around and just hand it to your other hand. Now I have him nice and smooth and I'm not throwing anything around my horse. Same way with the halter. When I put this halter on, I want my horse's nose to always go to it and I always want to have it right here where it's supposed to be. Buddy, come here, I know the flies are bad. So I want him to know how to get to this halter. If I do it every time, his nose goes in a halter. Every time, he knows. So he gets used to doing this. He's used to have my hand around him. He used to have me hugging him. He's used to me being in his space. I know you got an itch. Come on, I know. We're almost finished. We'll make this quick. So once I get this over his nose, I have two ends that I have to work with. Okay? I can hold this over his nose on the side. Now I got to get this rope on the other side of his neck. Here's the wrong way. That's the wrong way, people. This is a smooth, calm way teaching your horse that you have control and you're not making quick movements. I simply take this in this hand. Of course, Buddy's not going to listen. Come here, Buddy. I take this in my other hand, and then I'm going to hand it to my other hand on the other side. I'm going to reach under his neck. I'm going to slowly hand it to him, and now I have my horse. I have my horse's head. I can control him. I can stop his head from pulling away. I have total control and I haven't made any quick jerking movements. I'll show you nice and easy, one way, nice and slow. Buddy, we're not finished up, I know. So you come around, you put it on the nose, you hold it on the other side, you give your horse a hug, you reach over, you take the rope nice and slowly, and you pull around here and you tie your knot. And that's how you put on a rope halter. You don't come over the head. I see this all the time. I gotta get, and the horse is like, what the? Get off my ears, get out of my face, what the? And they're panicking and you got this rope here and you're like, stand still. Good Lord, ain't no damn wonder horses don't want to have a halter on. Think about your horse when you're doing things. Quit focusing on what you want to do instead of focusing on what you're doing to your horse and what are you teaching. I'm teaching my horse to trust me that it's smooth and it's okay to get a halter on. Cause you're a good boy and he wants a cookie cause he's a good boy. And he knows he gets his halter on the same way every time, no hassle, no throwing, no accidentally poking him in the eye, no flipping this around. That's how you put on a halter. I've talked about it before. I want to demonstrate it again. I still get things about, questions about it. Stay there, bud. You're still tied up. I know. You want your close-up? All right. We'll give you a close-up. Hang on. Buddy, boy, good boy. He gets his little close-up. All right. We'll end that there on how to put on a rope halter. Hope that helps. Good boy, bud.